As of now, when I'm shooting this video, there are 3 lakh plus registered cases in India. The second wave of corona has come bigger, stronger. It's shaking most of us. The kind of visuals and posts that we are seeing of bodies being burnt in cremation grounds. There are no enough cremation grounds or the spaces that have been created to dispose of these bodies. Oxygen cylinders are not available. There are not enough beds in our hospitals. What are we doing, India? Why are we not taking this crisis so seriously by wearing masks, maintaining social distancing? Why are we still so ignorant about this whole scenario? To all those people who are watching this video, it's a humble request to stay very, very careful, stay very safe, and be very organized, be very disciplined, be very serious about this crisis that has happened or is happening. Lockdown again, because it's not a very pleasant scenario where the lockdown with loss of jobs and situations and shops and shutters are down. A lot of loss is happening of people who are losing their livelihood. There's depression everywhere. There is so much that's happening globally. And everyone is sending good wishes and support to India. Let's be serious, India. As far as corona is concerned, let's be very, very careful, because as we know, it's attacking our immunity, it's attacking our ability to breathe, think. We are in a panic. In this time when, even if you come to know that there are symptoms like cough, cold, running nose, some sort of sensation in the nose of smell missing, headache, or temperature rising, please do not panic. Isolate yourself, sit at home, do not take it lightly. Oh, I can go to the gym, I can go down for a walk, I can, invite people over for some sort of an interaction. Especially when you have children around. Let's understand that the four areas where corona is actually affecting us. Starting from the headaches and cold and cough are the first symptoms that you're finding. From there, it comes into the throat and stays there for up to 3 days, and this time it's even for longer. Even after, there are many people who've taken COVID vaccinations, have known many people, even after that they got corona, which means that this is something which is happening for a certain reason for the humanity. Let's understand compliance, let's understand authorities, let's understand the norms that the government is setting us for, not to go out on the roads or go in the marketplaces or crowded places, not to invite people at home. All of these is for a reason. Kindly stay aware and alert with the ongoing situation of the second wave of corona. Let's take it very, very seriously, guys. It's not to be taken that lightly. And now let's talk about the symptom, beginning from the headache and the cold and cough. Anything that is a cold and cough is basically an ENT issue. Your throat chakra, the seven chakras, the energy alignment that we have with our physical body. There are 72,000 meridians through which the energy is flowing, and that is why emotions are called emotion, energy in motion. The way more you panic is more it is affecting the way the energy is flowing within your system. And that is what is causing all these various symptoms to aggravate. So headache is about the confusion and no clarity in decision making. So if all of you are panicking into some sort of a situation where you're not able to make effective decisions, simply just think about all those areas, all those aspects of your life that are making you confused to move forward in life. Just simply breathe it out and say, I choose to let go. Just simply keep tapping on the Ida Pingala, which is ending here in the beginning of your eyebrow, and the very important energy center, which is about your Agya Chakra. Tap there for the headache and just simply breathe it out. Take 3 deep breaths and think about that particular factor which is keeping you completely worried and overthinking, and let it go. While tapping on both these points and letting go of that factor which is keeping you really, really engaged into something which is very heavy and confusing that you're not able to let go. So start doing that with 6 to 7 breaths and you will be easy. For those who are not able to express, start tapping here on the collarbone or on the throat, the muscles that are tensed or tight. I breathe through life easily and effortlessly. I express fearlessly. I am in complete harmony with my environment. As you are breathing all these feelings out for which you are not able to express, even when you are feeling trapped at home, sitting in one room, you have nobody to talk to, Everything that is making you feel heavy, just start tapping that part of your body and start letting it go through your breath. Breath itself represents life. Do not panic, because the more you perceive life to be very, very difficult, the breathing will become difficult. Calm down, ground yourself. Imagine a shaft of white light which is coming in through the cosmos, passing through your crown and the third eye, through your throat, slowly, gradually coming in through down, relating with the people in your environment, with your heart, going down with your solar plexus, simply releasing all the fears and insecurities about whatever that's happening, releasing all the vulnerabilities, all the loss of confidence that has happened, coming down to the sacral and dynamism, where you have the disconnection with people around in your environment, just letting go of all these imbalances. Finally, leaving through your tailbone, which is the coccyx region, from both your legs, going deep down into the core of Mother Earth. You are simply one with the cosmos and the earth and the core. Simply breathe in and out all this heaviness and difficulty that you've been facing while you're being infected by this situation. Every day, sit for about just 5 minutes and connect with this shaft of white light passing through all your seven chakras with harmony, releasing all the no clarity in decision making aspects, fear, insecurities, any sort of difficulty in self-expression, and letting go of vulnerabilities, and life is easy, life is smooth. These are the things which I want you to keep simply focusing, and that is how you will fight corona. Even while you are with medications and antibiotics, I want you to dedicate at least 5 minutes through the day to breathe in easy. As and when the breath becomes difficult, just simply center yourself, ground yourself, and give all that discomfort and heaviness that you're not able to deal with, give it to Mother Earth. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay calm. Maintain social distancing. Sanitize your hands. Wear the mask when you go out. Thank you so much. I'm Rajesh Singh from Happiness Solutions, thanking each one of you to share this video to as many people as possible so that resilience and calmness can be spread. Thank you very much.